Looking at fields in Europe today, monocultures dominate the picture. Growing multiple crops, such as legumes and cereals, in the same field at the same time is rarely done. However, this intercropping technique offers numerous advantages that can lead to a more resilient and sustainable agricultural future. The EU research project Leguminose is investigating these benefits.
Our idea is to see how this kind of cropping system can have an impact on soil fertility, on plant production, so it can help the farmer community to use the less fertilization, less pesticides.
To do this, the project has established 7 research fields in different climatic zones of Europe. Here, legumes such as peas and soybeans will be grown with cereals, such as wheat or barley, in the same field at the same time. The researchers will then study the effects of this intercropping.
In this project, we focus on many different type of data. So we will measure different kind of soil properties, starting from soil chemical and physical properties, and also the yield of the plants, depending on intercropping strategies. And also we will evaluate the quality of plant.
In addition to the soil properties and plant quality, there is a third important component, the microbes living in the soil. Microbes recycle nutrients in the soil and make them available to the plants. Increasing microbial diversity enhances soil health and promotes plant growth. One way of assessing soil fertility is by measuring its carbon content.
I'm taking samples for determination of the bulk density of the soil. It's an important parameter if you want to calculate the amount of or the stocks of carbon or nutrients which are in the soil.
Soil organic carbon is important to consider in the context of climate change. Healthier soil can retain more carbon, which means that less carbon is released into the atmosphere in the form of CO2. In addition to soil carbon, the researchers are also interested in nitrogen.
There's a lot of benefits from intercropping. So the most obvious and well-known one is that the legume is fixing nitrogen from the atmosphere. And there's studies that have been shown that it's able to transfer some of that nitrogen that it's fixed to the cereal plant. So providing nitrogen from the atmosphere rather than nitrogen from inorganic fertilizers. But our understanding of exactly how that happens is imperfect at the moment. And so we're hoping through this project to understand a little bit about how and when that happened.
The research project will continue until 2026 with regular analysis of all 7 research fields. This research will pave the way towards more sustainable farming practices.